excited to have you guys here for the CrossFit Level 1 course. For you guys, it's essentially a two-day camp where we're gonna give you as much of CrossFit as we possibly can in the 2 days that we have with you guys. And this is a program that is the very first of its kind, and our goal is to give young ladies and gentlemen just like you guys the opportunity to have all of what CrossFit is about. So our opportunity to expose you is something that we take very, very seriously.
Atlanta Leadership Club is a small nonprofit here in Atlanta. We work with families and kids from underserved populations here, and mainly we focus on teenagers with the idea of job skill, life skill development. CrossFit Scholarship Program came along where we are able to bring kids into a safe, sanitized space with some really cool activities and focusing on fitness and health and how to build them into better humans, which is something that's super exciting because we haven't had that in a few months of just like in-person interactions. This has been really amazing for that.
It can be misconstrued that you have to make this huge, big splash to have impact. And honestly, I think, you know, with what little work I've had in the past of this type of an involvement, I think the biggest thing that we've given is just an opportunity, another exposure to recognize that there's something else that's beyond whatever is your everyday life. The level one, being able to come to a facility where you know that the things that are happening there in the facility are geared towards health and fitness is a huge thing. But then in addition to that, to share kind of like a common bond of all the things that are going on the planet right now, in addition to the athletic side of things, it's just been a really good experience, not only for the kids, but obviously for us as leaders and those that are designed to kind of paint some of the picture going forward for these kids.
I believe that the level one is incredibly profound. It was profound for me. It changed literally the course of my entire life, and that's the exposure that we want to give these kids, because we know that it's more than just a fitness program. It changes what happens between the ears, and that can affect their future potentially in really positive ways.
Feet underneath the shoulders, wide grip on the bar, bring that up overhead. Good, press up, pits forward, and again, show me your name tags. Ready? And squat.
Right now, the things that are on my mind are primarily what's next for these kids. We've given them a great opportunity to expose them to some of this knowledge and the information that's out there, and to see the excitement from them and start to plan their after-school activities and be able to figure out new ways to stay off the streets and do some more productive and active things in their life. That's the part that really resonated with me so far, and to see the kids talk about that and hear them get excited about it, I think that's mission accomplished with this seminar.
Yeah, there you go. Start coming up. Good, and keep the bar close.
Literally, 15,000 other people have taken the level one and then opened up a small business and provided for themselves and their families. And we're basically giving these youth, young adults, an opportunity to a skill set to where if they chose to down the road, they could open up a gym and make a living off of it. We're not just exposing them to CrossFit and teaching them how to do CrossFit, we're giving them the tools and the foundation to actually be a trainer if they so choose to go down this path. We're putting our boots on the ground and we're making a difference, and we're leading by acting.
Sick, well, and fit. And a better way to look at this is, I'm in trouble, I need a doctor's help, I'm doing okay, and over here, I'm doing so good, my doctor wants to know what I'm doing. Like, he's interested. Unfortunately, though, if most of our communities are sitting here, they don't have far to go before they're really in a bad way. Because we see fitness as a hedge against sickness, with wellness as the intermediate step, right? We are looking for a balance of lifestyle here. And this lifestyle thing is kind of a little bit of our responsibility, is what it means. But that kind of assessment is what's gonna make you make meaningful decisions about everything in your life. What am I gonna eat? Who am I gonna hang around with? What's my workouts gonna be like? All of that stuff can be quantified right there, okay? Cool.
Four and four, four stomps, four claps. Here we go, one, two, three. Sweet, all right.
Hey, we wish you could be here, man.
He said thank you.
Good to see you, buddy.
We'll get you in here when you get better, in like 3 days, right? He was supposed to be here this week, but he was shot. couple weeks ago. So he's doing good. He's doing a lot better now. So he's out of ICU and he's breathing on his own and stuff. So that was him. He was waving. It was so good to so good to see him. He's good. Thank God.
All right, guys. Whenever you're ready, say get well to Trayvon.
Get well, Trayvon. They wish you were here. Yeah. Before you can get big, like say, you see Chuck over there. You see how big Chuck is. We trying to get like Chuck, but we can knock somebody on the field. But we sorry you got hit and shot. We wish you were there. We miss you.
I came in this weekend thinking that we're providing something for the kids. And I think what ended up happening was they provided a lot more for us. I think that it just proves the fact that, I don't know, man, you think you have the answer sometimes, and then you show up and you find out that that you might have a lot, but you might not have all the answers. This weekend, who knows what it's gonna turn out to be for these kids? Who knows, man? It may just be another weekend that they get a chance to be away from whatever circumstances or take a couple minutes to just not have to think about certain things that are going on. And that's one avenue. But the other avenue is that they have the same level one that I had. I mean, they have the opportunity that the trainers worldwide that are 14, 15,000 gyms are getting. This is their initial exposure.
Yeah.
This is a spark. And I think that the tendency may be to look at short-sighted. I don't think we're gonna know until 10 years down the road what this opening weekend is gonna be, or has been, yeah. And that's okay, and I'm okay with that.